Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Eden's Secret. So, first off, I just thought I would show you all the massage bars that I made last night, the ones I showed you me pouring. These are the angel skin, just drying off a little bit. They're actually quite moist when you first take them out of the mold, but I took these out last night and they've dried off nicely. And these are the love spell ones that I did. So you'll see how nice they look with the hearts picked out on top. And I've made them a little bit brighter. The hearts were a lot paler, in the last lot that I sold off. So that's those. Something I've been dying to show you, but was going to save these until later. I'm actually on working on my Valentine's products, and this here is a candle. So, and that not only is it a candle, but it's a massage candle. The topping in here you can use as a massage oil. So I know lots of you have heard of massage candles, and what happens is when you burn the wick down, you let all of the wax melt into a pool, and then you just pour it on and massage it in like you would a massage oil. So I'm delighted with those. I am going to be making a few more just in nice usable sizes. These are made in a shot glass. If I had a proper glass, I could show you how big they are, but that's how big it is compared to a bottle of water. But yeah, I've been practicing working on this recipe for the last 4 weeks now, and I've managed to get a consistency that I can pipe quite a few pipings with. And obviously also wanted it to melt as a massage oil. So that's those. And the other thing I wanted to show you is to talk about making soap in your kitchen. You can see what happens if it splashes onto solid wood. I'm sure it'll be the same if you've got a plastic kitchen or a laminated kitchen. Luckily, I'm actually getting a new kitchen sometime. And but I just wanted to warn anyone that is making soap in their kitchen, if you don't want your unit spoiling, you're going to need to cover it up. What does work really well with soap is granite or marble. That doesn't mark or stain or anything, so you can splash and splash and splash away. You can even pipe onto marble or granite, that's what we call it. And it doesn't hurt it or harm it in any way. So, what you can see here, these are the molds ready to go for my Fairies Dance massage bars. I've got some purple oil in here. Now, this will probably be lilac when it sets because obviously it's mixed with white. So, I just pour each one of these. And again, the other great thing about the marble or the granite is it's very cold, very, very cold. A lot of pastry chefs use marble because it's cool and pastry's best made on a cool surface, apparently. So what's great about this is hopefully by the time I get to the end and I've poured these, I'll be able to pour the rest of pour the rest of the massage bar recipe on top of this. It might not quite work out like that, but hopefully we'll not be far off. And this does smell so delicious. I've sent a lot of these to people in the States, and it's a scent they've never ever smelt before. It's jasmine. It's quite an edible smell, mind. It's jasmine, amber, freesia, of course, vanilla and edible scents as well. But everybody likes it. Beanie from Fox Run Soap and Sundries describes it as a very Victorian scent. And while I'm on, I also just want to thank you all for the orders. I don't actually think I've ever had as many orders as I'm getting in this sale, even in the run-up to Christmas. So I am struggling just a little bit to get on top of them. So if you've placed an order today, it might be 2 days before I actually get to the point of being able to pack them. But when I've poured these, I'm going to be starting to pack orders again today, and I've got a ton going out. So just bear with me. I could have like a 2 day turnaround at the moment. Now, from what I see, I don't think. Oh, yes, it is. It's fine. It's ready to be poured on top of. I actually love these spoons as well. These are a melamine spoon with the slits in. They're great for stirring up whatever recipe that you're making. So I've got two. This isn't a full jug because I've been overly filling the jugs, and you can't actually pour neatly if your jug is full. So I've split it into two jugfuls. And what you need with this is no good because it's actually melting. Can you see it's melting the colour below? I don't want that. So I'm just going to break off from filming, and I'll try and come back and film and then join them together in a YouTube video maker if I can. Hopefully it'll not be too difficult, but it's something I've only had a little bit of a dabble at before. So I'll see you very, very soon for the next installment of the Fairies Dance Massage Bars. Bye for now. So hiya, here we are, I'm back again. Not that I went away, if I can manage to do this video right. So now we should be perfect to pour these on, because you don't want the bottom bit to be rock hard unless the oil that you're pouring on top of it is quite hot, because obviously you want them to stick together. And this mold is the perfect size for massage bars, and I always just overfill it slightly. I don't know what the weather's like with you, but for us, it's been wild, absolutely wild, wet and windy. I'm sure if you're in the UK, you have had exactly the same for a couple of weeks now. My nose is burnt out with fragrance now. It takes a lot of fragrance for me to smell anything. But every time I go into the post office to take boxes, the girls are going, Oh, it doesn't it smell gorgeous? Don't the dick. And the only time I can ever smell is if I've been on holiday for a couple of weeks. And I can sort of smell it when I just come back into the house, but I'm totally immune. We had a kitchen guy around the other day, as I said, I'm messing up here. I've designed the utility, the space in the soap kitchen. And we're going to, hopefully, if we can afford it, get a kitchen for in here as well. And the guy who came said the smell was really, really strong. It's okay if you, if it runs over the edge. You can just scrape it back on with one of the scrapers that you use. I'll just show you how to do that in a second. That's if there's room, of course. Right, that's it for now. I'll have to go. The phone's ringing. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.